Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Manish Porwal. I'm the co-convener of this webinar along with Dr. Anurag Batra, the editor-in-chief of the Business World Group. Welcome to Business World Marketing and Alchemist Presents COVID-19 CelebBiz The Aftermath in association with Exchange for Media and Entourage. It's a webinar to discuss the changing dynamics of the celebrity and brand association business. COVID-19 CelebBiz The Aftermath webinar is an industry first.
Today, if you look at TV advertising, which is where most celebrities come in, 12% of what is spent on TV and about 45,000 crores is spent on TV is spent on celebrities. So will that grow? Will that come down? Second is, celebrities are not being seen enough physically. There are no shoots happening, no new movies being released, no events happening, no appearances happening. So with these two opening remarks, I would like to request Maman to come in and give his opening comments and lead the discussion.
I feel for quite some time, celebrities will be shooting their own, they'll be directing their own ad films, something that they thought they were doing all along in their careers to begin with. I think that the day of pointing at a pack is over, in my opinion. I think that is now, yeah. Is passé, over, it should have ended long time ago. Maaf kijiyega. But having said that, I still feel that another big deciding factor and a tipping factor would be, how good is the ad itself?
Everybody can see the digital world is going to take over more than ever after this. There are already so many ways and means of using the digital world that we have been introduced to in these last, 40-45 odd days. Yeah, I mean, smaller short-term campaigns is what I feel as a celebrity, people would want to, start, shoot something yourself and put it out there, you know, like in your own house. That probably the theory of relatability will come into play even more because you feel more
authentic.
Yeah,
they can relate to you. Tapsi is one of us.
I feel the clutter on digital, the clutter on OTT platform will rise. And we always used a celebrity or a spokesperson who can connect with the brand to cut through this clutter and increase brand saliency. So in the new age or in the new time, the short term, I think the relevancy of using a spokesperson will still be higher.
I think there has to be a win-win between brand and the brand ambassador. And we all need to adjust to a new COVID life because discretionary income will be lower both for companies and consumers.
The amount of authenticity that is needed at this current time is a lot more than ever before. And all brands and celebrities have to look at that aspect.
From a brand side, I think the category mix will change. F&B, personal care, and those set of categories which rely largely on celebs will continue to remain the same. I think that will not change dramatically. But the casual usage of celebs will go down. From the celeb side, I think there will be a move from the fixed time, fixed fee model to a slightly more blended model.
I must add that it'll go way beyond conventional popularity. It must be the person behind the personality. There must be resonance between who the talent is and what they're standing for. The conventional on-ground experiences, for very obvious and evident reasons, will take a while before it comes back.
Ladies and gentlemen, what we have here is what could be called somewhat learned and logical interpretation of what we believe could happen. The new 2020 rule, and not IPL 1, is that the endorsement market, earlier increasing by about 20%, actually 19% odd in value each year, is now expected to increase by 5% in number of deals, that is the volume, but decrease by about 20% in value. Celeb appearance market therefore will be down by about 70% than the previous year in the next 6 months. The people who have to worry most is the A+ variety of celebrities. There'll be smaller but sharper influence celebrities with shorter span of celeb life who will be in the trend. With Instagram, TikTok, YouTube, etc., brands will focus on creating relevant content. About 5% of the large endorsement deals will feature maybe a performance clause. The costing matrix would for the first time start changing from input-based to output-based. But the average retainership or relationship for a celebrity with a brand is about 1.5 years right now. That'll go down to 10 months. Digital usage will further push the value, giving more social chatter. Those celebs who give more social chatter, allow more social chatter in their deals, will get better and give more value. there will be a lot of existing brands that will move out of celebrities and actually newer ones walking in. There will be an added pressure on the celeb economy overall, and therefore the celeb managers will have added performance pressure.
When he talked about the niche stars, do we see news anchors, some star news anchors also coming in as brand ambassadors in the near future?
You know, eventually at the end of the day, what I learned in theatre comes to the fore, that, you know, if you believe you're the person who can actually be that character, then the audience will believe.
Kya aapko ye bataya ki aapko bhi line ke us paar ya is paar khade hone ki avashyakta hai? Beech line mein khade hokar jange nahi jeeti jaati.
I generally feel either way one should take a stand. If a director is making a movie, he should take a stand that this is my point of view. Wo to koi bhi cheez mein stand to lena hi hai. Is paar us paar ka sawal hi nahi aata.
And have a great and a safe next few days. Please take care. Do not go out. Immediately as the lockdown just opens, take care. Shabakhair. Thank you so much. Thank you.